Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the fourth episode to create a responsive website using React and Design. In the previous episode, we work on header and layout component. And today, we'll work on hero using carousel component. First of all, open your app.js. And since we'll be working on hero, which is part of the content, let's add content which we removed in our previous session. Then let's create a hero component. So I will create a new folder called home, and then I will create a new file called hero.js. Then import React from React and create a function called AppHero. Then let's add a content called Hero Block. Then let's use export default AppHero. Before working on this component, I want to create one more component called App Home. This is because I want to organize all the components. So in the App Home component, I will add all other components which belong to the home page, like hero, about, features, and so on. So let's create a new folder inside this src, and then let's call it views. Then let's create a new file and call it home.js. Then let's change the component name into app home, and then we can also change this content into home page. Now let's use this app home component inside this app.js. So the first thing we need to do is to import app home from views and home. Then let's use the app home tag. Now if you check the site, you should see the app home component. Currently it is hidden under the header because it has got this fixed position, but we are good to proceed since our content stood so at the middle while working on the carousel. Now let's import hero inside the app home component. So the first thing we have to do is to import app hero from components home and hero. Then we can remove this content, and instead we can add a div tag with a class called main. Then let's add the app hero tag. Now if you check the site, you should see the content from the hero component. Here you go. Since we finished adding new app hero component under app home component, let's work on adding carousel now. So open your Ant Design website, click on components, and then click on carousel. Then let's use this example. So click on the show code, and then the first thing is we have to import the carousel from Ant Design. So let's import carousel from Ant Design. Then let's create a div with a class called hero block. Then finally let's copy all of this carousel tag. You can remove this attribute. take your side, and then you should see a carousel over here. Now, since our design got some title, content, and the button, let's try to add them. So I'll add this title and content inside the items array. So I will just paste my code over here. Then to use this data, I will use JavaScript's map function. And use single braces to get individual data, for example, item.content. You can remove this unwanted div. Now check the site and you should see our content over here. Great. Now let's add the title and the button. I want to add the title in the s3 tag. item.title. Then let's add a p tag for the content. Then finally for the button, let's create another div with the class called btn holder. Now to get the button, you can again open the end design site. You can click on the button component, then click on show code. You can copy any one of the button and then paste it over here. Then we have to import button from end design. I'll add button over here. We have got two buttons, so I will copy and paste it over here. Then if you want the large button, then you can add the attribute and call it large. The second button, I don't want it to be primary, so I can remove this type equals primary. Then I can simply add the button name. The first button is the learn more and the second one is what's a demo. Check your site again and this time you should see a title and a buttons. Now the only thing we are missing is this font awesome icon. So let's use a developer tool and let's copy that icon and paste it over here. Check your site again and this time everything is looking exactly the same as in design. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll be working on About Us using grid system. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.